So check it out. I got the Pico finish here. So let me throw a few freezes in there and play around with it a little. Once we get rolling and we've got some stuff, I'll transfer it over here and I'll build a little breakdown. We'll bring it in. Like how crazy, bro. You know that we can do that now,
brother. That's awesome. It's like you know, seeing an awesome artist and you ask him to do a painting on the spot, asking you to, are you doing that on the spot? You know what I mean? You know, so that's awesome to have you, you know, draw up a fight and stuff like that, just on a moment's notice, like, all right, let me draw this up and bam, bam, bam. Yeah. You know, so.
Yeah, we're going to do it. So he's leaning into the thigh. So some people call it a chest pressure takedown. We go in, we've got it, and we lean into the thigh. And then often, you can reverse that, but he leans into it. I'll put a freeze in there and then I'll draw. He leans into it, uses the response. And again, just like you get a guy to jab, he slips out to the side and you walk him into a kick. He uses the response off the chest pressure to get up underneath him. So we'll build that in. And I'll throw something in there, down there, and then switch. Oh, man, it's nice. It's
an awesome experience for a lot of people, too, to get to see your mind frame behind the scenes of how you are working on one of your projects and your videos and stuff like that. It gives them a live and in-person, up-close and personal view of the mind of Robin Black creating.
Oh, thanks, man.
They could see it as it happens. This is really cool.
Do you guys want to take a look at this Aaron Pico piece
that Let's do it. We couldn't say no to you working one of your masterpieces on the spot. You know what I mean?
I built it up and I sent it in. So Aaron's in on the single, right? And this is chest pressure. So you guys know chest pressure. And as soon as the man responds, you go in the other direction. So he's going to get up underneath him right here and then watch scoop. And then this is a done deal, right? And as soon as he's going to hit the ground, we saw some passing. We'll jump to the end, and then we'll go back to it. He's going to come up here, and this right hand, watch, it punches him into the choke. Think. Ooh. Look at that. Like, that's dirty, right? And it's not an accident. It's not an accident. That's how Nate Diaz finished Conor McGregor.
Conor, yep.
Yeah. And a couple of things here. He's looking for inside control. You can go to the bicep or to the armpit. When he responds, instead, you dig the underhook and he's going to try to pressure on the knee and go to pass here. It's not there immediately, but watch with a few small adjustments out, research, go back in, and now goes in and he starts to strike from here. This is what led to being able to get to the back. As soon, so much pressure here, it opened up the back. When we get back to the back, you can see one more time this sexy choke punch. He literally pops up, right knuckles temple, right into that choke. Filthy.